Hi friends, welcome back to Learn and Explore. Today, in this video, I am going to discuss with you all a very important topic of survey engineering, that is GIS and GPS. Before going to start my video, if you are new to our channel, please do subscribe our channel. And if you think that this video will help you, please do like, comment, and share with others so that others also can get help from our video. This MCQs will definitely help you in your upcoming competitive exam related to civil and survey engineering. So without wasting much time, I'm going to discuss all the questions one by one. And here it is my first question. So our first question is, which of the following formats can be used in GIS output, right? So our options are DXF, PDF, GIF and HTML. So in GIS output, T format, JPG format and GIF formats are used as GIS output. Okay, so in our option we have GIF. So our option will be C. C will be our right answer. GIS output use GIF format. Rather than this, we also use TIFF and JPG format. Okay, so we have to remember TIFF and JPG formats are used in GIS output, right? So I'm going to my next question. So our next question will be, in the process of GIS digitalization is done for better option. We have to justify this sentence. In the process of GIS digitalization is done for better output, right? So digitalization involves the conversion of the data from raster to vector so that the hardware data can be obtained in software, right? It can be done either by manual interpretation or by digital scanning. So digitalization is definitely done for better output in GIS process. So our answer will be A. Sentence is 100% true. Next question. Which among the following is not related to GIS softwares? Okay. So our options are CAD, ArcGIS, ArcView and StatPro. Among these all softwares, StatPro is the one which is particularly used for structures and its analysis in civil engineering field. Okay, and it's not used in GIS as GIS software. So our answer will be D. StatPro is not related to GIS software. Rest of the softwares like CAD, ArcGIS and ArcView are GIS softwares. So we have to keep in mind. So our answer will be D. Next question. Among the following, which do not come under the components of GIS? So we have to know what are the components of GIS. So GIS have many components such as hardware, software, user and data. So basically GIS contains four components: hardware, software, user and data. So here user is missing. And on the place of this, complier is here. So complier is not the component of GIS. So our answer will be C. Complier is not the option component of GIS. Okay. And the fourth component of GIS is user. We have to keep it in mind. User. Okay. Here I have some writing problem. So you please keep it on your mind. So our next question is, data can be shared in the process of GIS. So again we have to justify this sentence, right? So data can be shared in the process of GIS. Definitely not, because the entire function of GIS involves developing a map or detailed analysis of the area taken for development. In this, data can be analyzed but cannot be shared. Our answer will be B. Data cannot be shared in GIS. So this data can be shared in the process of GIS. So our answer will be B, false. Data cannot be shared in GIS, and this is one of the most or major drawback of GIS, that it cannot share the data. Okay, so please keep it on your mind, GIS cannot share this data. So next question, which of the following does not determine the capability of GIS? Okay, which of the following does not determine the capability of GIS? Defining a map representing cartographic feature, retrieving data, transferring data. Okay, so capability of GIS determines its ability to accomplish the work assigned, right? So it can define a map with database, can represent cartographic features, can store and retrieve data, and many more. By doing this, it can act as source or source for development of errors, but it cannot transfer the data from data. Okay, so our answer will be D. GIS cannot transfer its data. It's not the capability of GIS. Our answer will be D. Next question. Which of the following acts a benefit of GIS? So the benefits or advantage of GIS, there are a lot of advantages of regarding the uses of GIS, right? They include the maintaining geospatial data, value added products, productivity, efficiency of data, can save time and money both, right? So which of the following acts as benefit of GIS? Definitely maintaining geospatial data is the one of the benefit of GIS. Rest of the options, our answer will be A, maintaining geospatial data. Next question, which among the following is a server based hardware platform of GIS? So Autodesk Revit, StatPro, ArcGIS, Google Map. Among this, Google Map is a server based platform, remaining are offline applications only. So our answer will be D, Google Map is only server based platform, and remaining are offline applications only. So our answer will be D. Next question, among the available formats, which are most commonly used in case of GIS? So before I am told you that GIS used many output formats like GIF, TIFF, JPG, right? So among this, TIFF is the most used or commonly used format of GIS. That is, answer is B, TIFF. Our option will be B. Okay, so our option is B, TIFF. Next question, the point data feature can be used to represent location, area, 3D area, and volume. So our option will be A, the point data feature can be used to represent a location. Okay, A, so our answer will be A. Next question, the polygonal data feature uses which of the following data format? Scientific character, math, character, integer. Okay, the data formats which are generally used in case of GIS are what? Integer, float, and text format, right? So here our option is D. Okay, the polygonal data feature use integer data format. Rather than this, we have to keep in mind float and text format also used in case of GIS. Okay, so our option is D. Next question, which of the following indicate topographical primitive? Polyline, point, node, and polygon. Okay, so our answer will be C, node, because in GIS topological primitive are used. This includes node, faces, and edges. So rather than nodes, faces and edges are also indicate topological primitives in GIS? So our answer will be C. Okay, so our answer will be C. I'm very sorry for this writing error. Okay, so our answer will be C. Next question. Which of the following acts as a key to GIS? Okay, so our option is topology, platform, software, and train. So topology act as a key to GIS, as we all know. So our answer will be A. Okay, topology act as key to GIS. Next question. The figure represents which type of the error in GIS? So this question, you have to solve this question and write in comment box the answer and the reason why the answer is correct. Okay, so I am leaving this question up to you. Right, so I'm going to my next question. Which of the following can be used for representing a real world feature on two dimensional surfaces? So our options are plan, drawing, scale, and map. Okay, so obviously our answer will be B, map, because a map can be used for representation of real world feature on a two-dimensional surface. It can help in identification of location, locate route to a particular point. Generation of the map can be done in various ways, but the ultimate result is the same, right? So representing a real world feature on two-dimensional surface is obviously map. So our answer will be B. Next question. Which of the following sets represent the correct set of map classification? A, cadastral and thematic. B, thematic and geographic. C, cadastral, geographic. D, geographic and topographic. So in general, map has been classified into three categories, right? They includes cadastral map, topographic sheets, and thematic map. Each one is having particular importance and can be used only when it meets requirements. So we have here two classifications, that is cadastral and thematic. So our answer will be A, cadastral and thematic, and third one is topographic sheets. So we have to keep it on our mind. Next question. Which type of map can explain a particular feature in detail? Okay, so our options are cadastral map, topographic map, thematic map, and geographic map. Which type of map can explain a particular feature in detail? So our answer will be thematic map, because a thematic map involves in the generation of a world-class feature, which can be able to determine the parameters and features in the area of interest. This can be in ArcGIS software, right? So our answer will be C, thematic map can explain the particular feature in details. Next question. If the number on scale is less than 10, it represents a large scale map. So we have to justify the sentence. If the number on scale is less, then it represents a large scale map, right? So scale can be defined as the distance on map to the distance on the ground, right? There are different types of scale available, which can be selected based on the type of output needed. In order to have more accuracy, we need to go less number on scale, which indicate a large map with good details, right? So our answer will be A, obviously true. Okay, next question. The entire Earth surface is divided into zones in which type of map projections? Okay, so our options are polyphonic projection system, cylindrical projection, UTM projection, Lambert azimuthal equal area projection. So our answer will be C, UTM projections. Okay, because UTM projection is developed by US, it is capable of dividing the entire Earth surface into zones with 6 dimensions so that accurate location can be made by subdividing the classes. So the entire Earth surface is divided into zones in UTM projection, UTM map projections. Okay, the answer will be C. Next question. Which of the following is not a method of representation of the scale of the map? So our options are ratio method, verbal method, geographical method and non-verbal method. So in general, scale of the map can be represented by the three methods. Those includes ratio method, verbal method and geographical method. But non-verbal method is not a method which is represent the scale of the map. So our answer will be D, non-verbal method. Next question. Which of the following is having same principle as that of determining the position in GPS? So our answer, our options are compass, traversing, trisection and resection. So our answer will be D, resection, having the same principle as that of determining the position in GPS. Next question. Satellite generates which type of signals? Visible rays, X-rays, cosmic waves, radio waves. Right, so our answer will be D, radio waves. Satellite generates radio wave type of signals. Next question. Which of the following indicates the principle of GPS? Our options are resection, trilateration, trisection and traversing. So our option will be B, trilateration indicates the principle of GPS. Right, because trilateration is the principle involved in the case of GPS. This can be used to track or locate any movable object location. It involves mathematical operations which is regularly used in case of surveying. So the principle of GPS is trilateration. Our next question is, which among the following is used to locate an object? GPS, GIS, RS and IRS. So obviously our option is GPS. A, the full form of GPS is Global Positioning System. We have to keep it on our mind. Okay, our option is A. Next question. Satellite to user range can be calculated by using which of the following methods? Relative positioning, absolute positioning, aerial wave, pseudo ranging. Okay, so our answer will be D, pseudo ranging. Because pseudo ranging is the method, is the method of measuring distance between satellite and the receiver antenna. So our answer will be D, pseudo ranging. Next question. GPS can also be known as GOS, ArcGIS, GIS and Navistar. So our answer will be D, GPS or Global Positioning System can also be known as Navistar. Okay, next question. Trilateration is a plane surveying method. So we have to justify this line whether it is true or false. So trilateration is a method of plane surveying, right? So it is definitely right, because trilateration is the basic principle involved in GPS system, right? This was originally used in case of basic surveying, where the calculation involves a couple of mathematical operations. So trilateration is obviously a plane surveying method. So our answer will be B, true. Next question. Accuracy of the position through can be influenced by reflection, signal strength, position of satellite. So accuracy of the position through can be influenced by the position of satellite because there are certain factors which can affect the accuracy of the position obtained by GPS. Those are position of satellite, atmospheric condition, satellite clock errors, and satellite clock errors and other errors. Right. Among these, position of satellite is influenced. Okay. Accuracy of the position can be influenced by position of satellite. So answer will be D. Next question. Two satellites are enough for finding accurate position of the object. Again, we have to justify this sentence. So this is obviously false. Our option will be A, because for enough for finding accurate position of any object, minimum four satellites is required. Okay, so our answer will be A, false. Next question. Kinematic positioning will come under which of the following classification? Relative positioning, absolute positioning, resection method, and carrier waves. So kinematic positioning will come under relative positioning. Okay, our answer will be A. Kinematic positioning will come under relative positioning. Next question. Base receiver is kept stationary in which of the following operations? Stop and go positioning, kinematic positioning, first static positioning, static positioning. So base receiver is kept stationary in first static position. Our answer will be C. Okay, so next question. If the connection of the number of satellites decrease, the accuracy of the position increase. So again, we have to justify this sentence. So the accuracy of the position can be improved only if the number of satellites connected to the user are more, right? Generally, four satellites are required to connect and find any object. In general, must be four satellites are connected, so user can have better output. Okay, so if the connection of the number of satellites decrease, the accuracy of the position will increase. So our answer will be B, false. Okay, next question. The GPS time must be very accurate. So our answer will be true. Obviously, the GPS time must be very accurate. Our answer will be A. Next question. Which of the following is considered as modern GPS technology? GIS, GPS mode, instantaneous mode, kinematic positioning technique. So our answer will be D. Kinematic positioning technique is considered as modern GPS technology. Okay, so our next question is, absolute positioning is not useful in precise GPS. Right, so we have to justify this sentence again. Absolute positioning is not useful in precise GPS. So our answer is true, absolutely true, because absolute positioning is not much recommended in case of precise GPS. The fact that it lacks accuracy in its output. Okay, so absolute positioning is not useful because it lacks accuracy in its output. So our answer will be B. Next question. We have some time issue, so I am just explaining the question and the answers. And if you think that you need more explanation for any particular question, you can comment us and we will definitely try to answer you all. Okay, if you have any question in your mind, you are feel free to ask. We will try to answer you all. Right, so our next question is, which process can obtain more accuracy in position? Carrier wave method, absolute positioning, relative positioning, resection method. So our answer will be C, relative positioning. Which process can obtain more accuracy in position? That is relative positioning. Our answer will be C. Next question. Which of the following will affect the accuracy of the GPS position? Receiver station, signal, strength of signal, position of satellite, atomic clock. The GPS accuracy depends upon the receiver station and the atmospheric condition. Right. In case of dull atmosphere, the information transmitted cannot reach the receiver in at a full length. Right. So the signal. So receiver station. Which of the following affect the accuracy of GPS positioning? Receiver station affect the accuracy of GPS position. Accuracy of the GPS position. So our answer will be A. Next question. Which among the following can act as cause wrong GPS tracking? Right. Refraction of signal, strength of signal, atomic clock, reflection of satellite signal. So our answer will be B. Reflection of satellite signal can cause for wrong GPS tracking because it is known that sometimes GPS shows wrong placement of the location track. This is due to blockage of satellite signal by buildings, reflection of satellite signals, jamming of the signals, etc. Right. So our answer will be D. Next question. The accuracy speed of the GPS depends on reflection of signal, signal blockage, reflection of signal, position of satellite. Our answer will be B. Signal blockage. Right. The accuracy speed of the GPS depends on signal blockage and atmospheric condition and receiver design quality also. So rather than signal blockage, the accuracy of the GPS depends on satellite geometry, atmospheric conditions and receiver design quality also. We have to keep it on our mind. Right, so our answer is B. Next question. The clock used in GPS will synchronize to Greenwich, ITC, UTC and IS. So our answer will be C. The clock used in GPS will synchronize to UTC. Coordinate Universal Time. The full form of UTC is Coordinate Universal Time. Right? Coordinate Universal Time. Next question. Which among the following is the first Indian remote sensing satellite? Options are QuickBird, Spot, IRS-1A, MOS. Our answer is C. IRS-1A is the first Indian remote sensing satellite which was launched in the mid of 1980. It is capable of recording the reflected electromagnetic waves from the surface and transmits them to the ground station. Our answer will be C. IRS-1A. Next question. Remote sensing uses which of the following waves in its procedure? Electric field, solar waves, gamma rays, electromagnetic waves. So our answer will be D. Remote sensing use electromagnetic waves in its procedure. Okay. Next question. Which of the following field is used by the electromagnetic waves? That is, options are solar field, polarized field, electric field and micro field. So you can understand electromagnetic wave obviously used electric field. Okay, so our option is C. Next question. If the intensity of wavelength decrease, the energy released will increase, decrease, remain same and zero. So our answer will be A. If the intensity of wavelength decrease, the energy released will be increased because the relation between wavelength and energy release is inversely proportional. That is, if wavelength increase, energy produced by the body decrease. This can is given by Planck's theory. Right. So the relation between wave and energy release is inversely proportional. Okay, so please keep it on your mind. Next question. Gamma rays are having a wavelength of, our options is 0, greater than 0.03 nanometer, less than 0.03 nanometer, equal to 0.03 nanometer. So gamma rays are having a wavelength of C, less than 0.03 nanometer. Okay, so our next question is, EM waves, that is electromagnetic waves, varies from dash to dash, that is meter to nanometers, meters to micrometers, nanometer to micrometer, centimeters to nanometers. So our option will be A. The electromagnetic waves varies from meter to nanometers. Okay. Next question. Temperature on the sun is around 575 to 600 K, 7550 to 8000 K, 5570 to 6000 K, and 5750 to 6000 K. This question also you have to solve and write your answer in our comment box. Okay, so I'm going to my next question. Mapping involves which of the following? Soil details, boundary details, catastral details, population details. Right. So our answer will be C. Mapping involves cadastral details. Okay. So our answer will be C. Next question. In which aspect of agriculture GIS is used? Right. Our options are soil analysis, seed requirement, fertilizer, pesticides. So our answer will be A. Soil analysis. Okay. Next question. Which of the following is not a property of coordinate in GIS? Line of sight, origin, axis, and units of measurements. The coordinates which are used in GIS are having three properties. Those are origin, axis, and units of measurements. Each of the of these will apply in every aspect of GIS software. Origin, axis, and units of measurements all are property of coordinates in GIS, not line of sight. So our answer will be A. Line of sight is not a property of coordinates in GIS. Rest of this, that is origin, axis, and units of measurements, are property of coordinates in GIS. So our answer will be A. In this way, I am going to end my part 4 of solving questions, MCQ questions. If you have any question in your mind, please feel free to ask, and we will definitely try to answer it all. And if any mistake is there in my whole video, please let me know by commenting your valuable comment in our comment section. And thank you.